In this tutorial, we'll show you how to use the Gibson Assembly Primer Design tool, also known as the GAP tool. You can use the GAP tool to design primers for generating DNA fragments with homologous overlap regions. This tool is compatible for the use with Gibson Assembly HiFi one-step method or the Ultra method. To get started, navigate to SGIDNA.com and use the Resources drop-down menu to navigate to the tool. Please read the informational text on the GAP tool welcome screen and check I understand. Then click Start Now to launch the tool. You can use the Next and Previous buttons to navigate through the tool. And if you need help or further clarification while designing your primers, click on the Hint blue question mark button. To begin primer design, enter the name of your vector and vector sequence in FASTA format. The first line of a sequence in FASTA format has a greater than symbol followed by the sequence name and lines below, contain sequence data as G, A, T, and C only. Other characters used for nucleic acid sequences, such as N, Y, or R, will result in an error. After entering your vector sequence, indicate whether you intend to PCR amplify your vector. In the next steps, you'll identify the insertion site for your vector. First, choose whether the site will be determined by position or by restriction digestion. Select by position if you will use PCR to linearize the vector. In this case, a pair of PCR primers are designed to allow PCR amplification of the vector. Remember that homologous ends can only be added to the vector if PCR is used to amplify it. Select by restriction if you will use restriction enzyme digestion to linearize the vector. Homologous ends cannot be added to the vector in this scenario. After selecting by position, the vector sequence will be displayed. Click and drag the sequence to identify and highlight the insertion location. The tool will then design PCR primers that eliminate the sequence you have selected from the vector. After selecting by restriction, you'll be asked additional questions about your vector. First, choose whether you want to regenerate your restriction site. Then choose how many restriction digestion sites you will need. You will then input the vector 3' and 5' restriction sites. Next, click Scan Sites to map the restriction sites within the vector. If applicable, select the correct sites from the drop-down menus. The restriction sites will then be highlighted on the vector sequence, and the positions of the restriction sites will be identified. The following steps determine primers for the insert. First, indicate the number of inserts you would like to input. Then, enter the insert sequence in plain text, not FASTA format. If you have multiple inserts, list each insert in sequential order of location from 5' to 3' end of the final assembled construct. Note that inserts generated by restriction enzyme digest or DNA tiles cannot be placed adjacent to each other. After inputting your insert sequences, select the method of insert preparation. Choose from PCR, restriction enzyme digestion, or DNA tile. Your results are shown with a circular map depicting the complete assembled construct, with the sequence displayed below the construct. The insert sequence is in uppercase and highlighted, and the vector sequence is in lowercase. Click Next to view your primers. To simplify primer ordering, you can save your primer output by downloading the primer details as an Excel file or PDF summary. In the primer output, inserts are numbered in the order that they are entered into the design tool. F corresponds to forward primer and R corresponds to reverse primer. For additional assistance, please contact us by clicking the link on the screen, customer service at sgidna.com.